I always like to use the saying, I have CdLS, but CdLS does not have me, because CdLS does not define who I am as a person. And so what I'm trying to say is, don't let CdLS define who your child is. Let them decide what they can and cannot do.
So I always say that Emily's taught me so much more than I've ever taught her. She's taught me about accepting differences. She's taught me about loving who you are for who you are. Emily has taught me about perseverance and just accepting everybody for who they are.
Cornelia de Lange syndrome, CDLS, is a rare genetic condition that occurs in approximately 1 in 10,000 births. It's estimated that upwards of 30,000 people have CDLS, and most of them and their doctors have never heard of the syndrome.
Cornelia de Lange syndrome, or CDLS, is a condition that generally produces small size and some degree of developmental involvement. Has typical facial features, often small hands and feet, and other inner organ malformations. Some individuals will have minor learning disabilities and normal intelligence. Other individuals will have severe intellectual disability, and then there's everything in between. CDLS is always a genetic condition. It's due to a change in a gene that causes all of the effects. Most of the time, it's a spontaneous occurrence at conception, and it's never related to anything either of the parents did before or during pregnancy.
Now that we know many of the genes that cause Cornelia de Lange syndrome, I believe there's lots of value in finding the specific genetic change. As we start developing targeted therapies for kids with Cornelia de Lange syndrome, in the future, it's going to be very important to know what your gene change is, because those therapies are likely going to be targeted to very specific gene changes or changes within individual genes.
The challenges individuals with CDLS and their families face are often daunting. Many feel alone, isolated, in need of support and connection. The CDLS Foundation is a vibrant community of families, researchers, volunteers, and professionals. The Foundation connects families who share vital, valuable knowledge with each other and puts them in touch with experts and specialists in CDLS.
One of the best parts about the Foundation is that they create a community for us and a distant family or an extended family. And having a child with special needs can be difficult because people that have typically developing children or your friends and sometimes even your family don't know how to react. They don't really know what you need, and so the Foundation has activities that creates community. As parents of kids with special needs, we don't want to be pitied because we are just moms and our kids are just kids.
We want to be approached. If you have a child born in South Dakota where there isn't a CDLS program, you can contact us. You can find information through the Foundation website, learn about the diagnosis, and work with the families and work with us, and the families will be appreciative.
The Foundation is committed to reaching the 30,000 people who are without a diagnosis or are unaware of services available to them. If you or someone you know has a child with CdLS, the Foundation is here to help.